couple of days ago I picked up this amp, and I plugged it in today, and I think it's fantastic! Fantastic! It's called an Engl, and it's made in Germany. The preamp uses three ECC83 valves, and the power amp uses one EC83 and two 5881 valves. And this particular amp uses a 12-inch Celestion. This model is the Thunder 50 Reverb, was designed by Horst Langer. This amp also comes in a version without reverb, so if you don't want a beautiful long sustain and a nice whole sound, actually it's a spring, if you don't want that brilliance and that amazing sound, then you should take the one without the reverb. First thing I noticed when I picked it up was that it has an extremely strong grill, and at the back there's also a grill to protect all the valves and the electronics, so that's also, it's really good for on the road. When we turn the amp around, the first thing we'll find is a mains input. Then there's a footswitch plug, switches the amp from clean to lead and from crunch to lead. An effects loop, send, return, and how much of the effect you want to let in. Then there are four speaker outputs.
Turn on the lead, it's on the crunch channel, so now we're gonna get even more gain. Wow, holy shit!
Gain all the way up and the master volume almost all the way down, so you get a crunch kind of sound, but still clean if you play softly, very touch responsive. I have the bass at about 7, middle at 5, and the treble also at 6 or 7, and then I have the reverb halfway up. I turned the gain all the way down again, and the master up a bit more, so that I have a more of jazzy, clean sound, really clean. And I think I'm gonna turn the bass up a bit. So I picked up the humbucker guitar, I'm just gonna play some jazzy, clean stuff. Everyone knows that using a single coil guitar such as this one gets you a different sound. What I did was switch to the crunch channel, and I was on the bridge pickup of the guitar. Well, as you can see, I had the lead volume at about. Like I do in every demo, I tune my guitar down to drop D to get a metal sound, to see if the sound can take metal too. And I think it can.